what is really are the stuff of legend, aren't they? Well, we can reveal that the Black Country may soon have its own political party. It wouldn't be the first time that voters have been urged to switch from the bigger parties to none of the above. Rob Mayer has been taking soundings.
Oh, hi.
Who is it?
It's just canvassers.
As long as it's not that bloody Kenyan. Just take a leaflet and tell them to...
It can be hard to win as an independent. You need a unique selling point, maybe a single issue, or a gimmick won't do you any harm either. This Love Actually spoof video wasn't quite enough to win Jim Kenyon a Westminster seat, but he's been an independent city and county councillor in Hereford since 2011. He used to be with It's Our County, who also have a stronghold in Herefordshire, whilst in Stoke-on-Trent, the city independents have been running things in coalition with the Conservatives since ousting Labour in 2015.
I remember when the election results came out, people were coming into my office to check if it was true that we'd broke that mould. Councillors could do a much better job because of the freedom they'll have than if you were with a national party.
There are around 2,300 independent councillors across England and Wales. Many of them group together to pool resources and gain positions of power. Now, former UKIP members here in Dudley are hoping to do the same by setting up a brand new political party. Launching the Black Country Party on Twitter, they say it'll support truly independent councillors, leaving them to focus on hyper-local issues.
Far too long, the national parties have been there, and all they do is spout off at each other saying, your government's done this, your government's done that, our government's done this, our government's done that. And they take off, occasionally they take their eye off the ball of what they should be doing by representing the area they live in.
And they hope to reach further than Dudley, with eyes on seats in the other three Black Country boroughs of Walsall, Wolverhampton and Sandwell. But is it what voters want?
It's going to be good for the community, and we need somebody to step up and give good ideas.
We need something in our community with the Black Country to deal with the Black Country, because I know what we want and how to go about it.
Something different, something revolutionary. We need someone with a bit of spark, a bit of magic.
But just how hard is it to get a brand new independent party off the ground?
They have to have an occasion or an interest, leadership and organisation to set themselves up in the first place. They have to have a council or a leadership or an established set of parties that's pretty unpopular with the electorate. And best of all, if they can find a single issue around which to focus themselves, like the health services in Kidderminster, then that's what can be the catalyst. That's what can give it critical mass and turn it into a really successful, sustained movement.
With the main party struggling to unite around national issues like Brexit, perhaps it could be a chance for independents to plant their flag here.
Rob Mayer, complete with a very accomplished retake on that scene from Love Actually by the Herefordshire Independent Councillor Jim Kenyon. He also won a very respectable 11% of the vote in Hereford and South Herefordshire in last year's general election. And he's one of 20 independent councillors of one assortment or another on the council there. Well, down the line to Worcester, I asked Councillor Kenyon, why should people vote for independent candidates?
I think a lot of people, when they look at the national parties, they think none of the above, and that they want someone who's going to represent them and not represent big party politics.
Isn't the point of this, then, that it's all about grievance, disenchantment with the bigger parties, rather than a more positive vision of politics?
It could well be. I mean, there's a lot of that that goes on. But if you've got a good, strong, independent councillor that's working within their wards and getting things done, people appreciate that, and they get behind those individuals.
But you, for example, stood in the general election against Jesse Norman, the Conservative MP for Hereford and South Herefordshire, who is a senior figure in his party. He's a transport minister. Doesn't it do Herefordshire good to have someone with significant clout at the top rather than just, you know, the proverbial lone wolf, the little guy on his own?
Absolutely. You know, what you're saying is quite true. He's a big cheese in his party. However, he does sit on the fence on occasions and he does follow the party whip. I see the big parties like two bears wrestling. They'll wrestle and wrestle and wrestle. If you've got a lone wolf or a individual, perhaps a bee, sting like a bee, like Muhammad Ali did, you can get things done. But, you know, via the back door sort of scenario.
What is it about Herefordshire that's enabled independents of various sorts and shapes and sizes to win so much traction, so much support in that county?
Well, being a Herefordian, I'm sure I can say they all think we're a bit strange down there. But you know, people think there's a vast amount of people from various backgrounds, and people think a lot more about what's going on. You know, it's our county. There's independents. There's the Greens, and there's only a couple of Lib Dem councillors within Herefordshire, and there's no Labour. And so, you know, the independents in It's Our County form the opposition to the Conservatives.
From your experience in Herefordshire then, what advice would you offer to those in the Black Country who are setting up something similar or thinking about it?
Just believe in yourselves. Get into the communities, work hard with your communities, and just be honest with the people, and they will respond.
Jim Cunningham, Jim Kenyon, and of course that point about independent politics has certainly made inroads in Stoke-on-Trent at your party's expense particularly. So do you take the point that they can make a more authentic message than you do when you're tied to the agenda of a national party?
I don't think so. I mean, we have independents in Stoke-on-Trent, neighbouring Newcastle as independents, and in both times they've gone straight into coalition with the Conservatives. What it does demonstrate clearly is where parties are not felt to be as relevant as they could be in local communities, and that's something that all political parties need to take seriously, because independents are, I believe, a symptom of disconnect, and it's our job to try and reconnect with those communities. But certainly in Stoke, what I don't think people who went to vote independent in 2015 expected was to wake up with essentially a Conservative-run council.
But we did hear that talk about the spark, the magic, and if you look at Jim Kenyon's video there, you could say, some might say it's a gimmick, but others might say, well, it's enterprising to find a way of cutting through to get the message through, given that he doesn't have the larger party organisation that you two do.
Yeah, but I think you find councillors of all parties that cut through in areas where they traditionally may not have done as well as the National Party because of who the individual is. But let's take Stoke-on-Trent for a second. Councillor Conway featured in the package. He was a former Labour councillor. Okay. The independents in Stoke are people from former parties who have either left or have decided for some reason, normally when they're not up to scratch with the local party rules, to
be Conway isn't here to defend himself. But how much of a threat do you see this as? Because there is a sort of UKIP element in the Black Country Party, for example, and UKIP themselves are ticking up, as your government is perceived, to sort of backtrack a bit on Brexit. So it is an electoral threat to the Tories, isn't it, Harry?
Well, I think it's always important to have local councillors who are really rooted in their communities, but they also, of course, need to agree on a common a plan of action and have enough votes to control the council. And sometimes you get one or two independents, and that doesn't really help with that. And also, importantly, I think what you can see here with the elected West Midlands Mayor Andy Street, how he's been able to deliver for the Black Country by being connected in terms of delivery with national government and delivering for transport, for housing, for a devolution package.
But it has to be seen as a bit of a reflection, these local independents, on the disgruntlement, the disaffection with the main parties, fragmentation at the centre of both your parties, particularly on Europe, anti-Semitism in yours.
Yeah, absolutely. I congratulate Harriet for the obligatory Conservative mention of Andy Street in
Andy
the West
Street,
Midlands, which you know,
yeah.
You know, you and Michael Fabricant can rank that one up, can't you? But no, I mean, the genuine issue is, like, what are we as political parties doing in those communities? And I think Harriet's right. You do need a common set of themes. And the City Independents in Stoke-on-Trent are a political party. They call themselves independents, but they have a manifesto. They have a party whip. They are bound to vote in certain ways, which is why they're voting to sell green fields in the city. It's not independence if they're a party.
For the moment, thank you very much indeed. Right, so let's bring ourselves up to speed now with the rest of the political developments making the news here over the past week. Today's roundup is brought to us by Kevin Reid in 60 seconds.